In Mississippi, a white father and son have both been arrested, charged, and let out on bail after allegedly shooting at an African-American FedEx driver. Brandon Case is charged with attempting to cause bodily injury with a firearm, and his father, Gregory Case, is charged with conspiring with Brandon to commit aggravated assault. D'Monterrio Gibson says he was trying to find an address while delivering packages for his job at FedEx when he says he was chased and shot at by the Cases, the bullets hitting his work van. D'Monterrio Gibson is joining us now to tell us what happened. He is here with his attorney, Carlos Moore, as well. D'Monterrio, thank you so much. This sounds, this sounds terrifying. Can you tell us what happened?
Okay, so basically on the evening of January 24th, I was attempting to deliver a package to 417 Junior Trail, and I accidentally put the wrong address in, so I couldn't find the house. I eventually found the right address and proceeded to deliver the package to it. Upon doing it, I was approached by a white vehicle, and that vehicle chased me, tried to cut me off, and I miraculously got out of there. I went down the street about two or three houses after I got away from the initial vehicle, and there was a guy standing in the middle of the road holding a gun at my vehicle telling me to stop, which I did not do. They essentially just chased me out the city, and I had to file a police report after that. Shots were fired into my van as well. Yes, ma'am. That's a quick summary of it.
Very quick and helpful. And so you were wearing your FedEx uniform when they saw you outside of your van, is that right?
Yes, ma'am. I was fully dressed in FedEx uniform.
And what do you think the Cases were trying to do? Were they trying to kill you?
Honestly, in my humble opinion, I think they were, because after they fired the initial shots, they continued to chase me out of the city again. I say so. If you didn't succeed the first time, then I could just only imagine what they was going to do if they had caught me.
Did they say anything? What do you think their motivation was here?
I honestly have no idea. We had no type of interaction before they did what they did. No words were exchanged or anything like that.
Okay, and Carlos, can you tell us a little bit about D'Monterrio's interaction then with police once he got them involved here?
Yes, he immediately called the police that evening after he got to the interstate and informed his boss. The police did not take it seriously, so his boss went down with him the next morning to the station to make an official report. She showed them the bullet casings, the actual vehicle with the bullets in it, and the packages with the bullets, and then they started to believe him. However, they still allowed the Cases 8 days of freedom before they turned themselves in to the Brookhaven Police Department, spending less than a day in jail on a $75,000 and $150,000 bond. And so that's why the family has contacted me, because they wanted this to be taken seriously and for there to be real charges for the Cases.
D'Monterrio, when this was happening, and it's really just happened here recently, as you looked back on this after a little bit of time had passed, did you see similarities to the Ahmaud Arbery case?
Yes, ma'am. I can definitely see the similarities. And that's why I feel it's my responsibility to speak up, because Ahmaud Arbery didn't survive to speak up for himself. So I want to take that upon myself to do that for me and him as well.
So they're out on bail, and they were given time to turn themselves in. How do you feel about that?
Honestly, I kind of figured that was going to happen in the first place when I initially reported it, because, like I said, the officers were not taking me serious at all. Even when I went to the police station, they weren't taking me serious. So I kind of figured that was going to happen.
If this was a black father and son and you were a white FedEx driver, do you think this would be different?
Yes, ma'am, without questioning. I would have been arrested probably that same night and not given bail at all.
How has FedEx responded? Have they been accommodating to you?
Not really. I am currently on unpaid leave. They gave me up to 2 weeks off, but it's unpaid. They have paid for therapy. They haven't, like, really supported me in making the case progress forward, or I guess how I can say it. They haven't contacted me at all, except for, like, once since this whole incident went down. They said they was investigating. I haven't heard anything since, though.
You're on unpaid leave?
Yes, ma'am, currently.
Okay, and if you go back to work, I mean, where would you be working?
They told me they was going to try to work that out. I honestly don't know.
All right, I have actually just lost signal, but I know that you answered my question, so I'm going to ask you another one because I believe that our viewers are able to hear you. I know, Carlos, that you have suggested, you've requested that the FBI be looking into this incident as a possible hate crime. Can you tell us about that? And can you tell us what you have heard from the FBI?
Yes, I did ask the FBI to officially open a hate crime investigation 2 evenings ago. I understand that on yesterday they did go down to the Brookhaven Police Department and pick up the file. And so while they would not confirm or deny that they are investigating, we do believe that they have taken this case seriously. We've also informed the Department of Justice Civil Rights Division, and they have flagged the case, and they are considering opening an investigation as well. So Mr. Gibson is pleased that the federal government is taking this case much more seriously than the Brookhaven Police Department.
Okay, I can hear you again now, just so you are aware. But D'Monterrio, I just want to go back to the situation that you're in right now. So you were shot at in the course of your work for FedEx. You are now on unpaid leave. I'm assuming you needed leave. Tell me a little bit about why you decided you needed leave. I think we all know, but just explain why you're taking some time off.
Yes, ma'am. So initially, like, as soon as we left the police station, I was put right back on that same route, like the following day. I tried to go through my work. It became kind of overwhelming, and like my anxiety started acting up. I almost had like an anxiety attack, and I just felt like I couldn't handle it mentally. So I decided to seek therapy and just take a few days off, or as much time as I need off, rather.
I mean, look, it sounds incredibly traumatic what you have been through, what you're describing here, and we're going to continue to follow it. D'Monterrio Gibson, thank you for being with us this morning. Carlos Moore, thank you as well.